Which is on amplitude modulation. So in this lecture we'll define the amplitude modulation and its derivation for amplitude modulation. So these are the learning outcomes. At end of this session, students will be able to define and derive the equation of amplitude modulation in electronic communication system here. So this is we'll before starting to the amplitude modulation, just recall, what do you mean by modulation? So the modulation is nothing but you are going to change the characteristics of a carrier wave with respect to modulating signals. Okay, so that is known as a modulation. So the characteristics you are going to change is either amplitude, frequency or phase here. So if you are going to change the amplitude of a carrier signal, which is in proportional to the modulating signal, so that is known as an amplitude modulation by keeping frequency and phase constant throughout the process. Same way, if you are going to change the frequency of a carrier wave with the proportional to the amplitude of a modulating signal by keeping amplitude and phase constant, it is known as a frequency modulation here. Okay, so now we'll define the amplitude modulation. So amplitude modulation is generally used for transmitting the information via a radio carrier wave here. Okay. In amplitude modulation, the amplitude of a carrier wave is varied in a proportional to that of a modulating signal being transmitted here. Okay, so this was the definition of an amplitude modulation here. Now we'll derive the equation for the amplitude modulation. Okay, so we'll see the final output, what are the components in the amplitude modulation here. Okay, so let us switch over to the class. Okay, so now as we know, for modulation we required two signals, which is there. Okay, so this is modulating signal so this is an amplitude of an modulating signal, this is T. So one more signal, that is carrier signal whose amplitude is VC here. Okay, so this is carrier signal here. So if you define the equation for a modulating signal, so it will be Vm sine omega m of t. This is amplitude of an the modulating signal. This will be an frequency, and phase and frequencies are kept constant, so that's why we are not going to take this into this equation here. Similarly, for carrier equation, so it will be VC sine omega c t. So before starting to the equation, so we have to understand what do you mean by modulation index here. So modulation index is defined, that is Vm is equals to Vm by VC, that is amplitude of an modulating signal to the amplitude of an the carrier signal here. Okay, so which lies between 0 to 1. Okay, if you have to calculate in percentage, then we have to multiply by 100. So Vm by VC into 100 here, so you will get into the percentage. Okay, so now we'll have the amplitude of an AM wave, so we'll derive the equation. So for that we required one diagram. Okay, so this is an amplitude of an AM wave. Okay, so this is VC, this will be VM. Okay, and this total will be A, that is total amplitude of an Vm plus VC. Okay, and the equation for this modulating signal will be Vm sine omega m of t here. Okay, so first let us derive the total amplitude of an AM wave. Total amplitude of an AM wave. Okay, so we have A equals to VC plus Vm. VC plus Vm. So VC is equals to Vm sine omega m of t, because we are going to change with respect to amplitude of an modulating signal. That's why we have to take total signal, that is Vm sine omega m of t, instantaneous value of an the modulating signal here. Therefore, we are going to take common Vc 1 plus Vm by Vc sine omega m of t. So, which will be Vc, substituting the value of an m, that is m is Vm by Vc here, sine omega m of t. So, this is equation 1. Okay. So, now we will have the total instantaneous voltage, that is total instantaneous voltage of an AM. So, for that we has to be A sine theta, instantaneous voltage here. Okay. So, now substituting the value of an A into this equation. So, you will be having Vc 1 plus m sine omega m of t into sine omega ct. Okay. So, this is also one equation of an AM signal. Okay. So, now by trigonometrical relations like sine x into sine y, so we have to solve sine x and sine y. So, which is half cos x minus y minus cos x plus y. Okay. So, this is the relation. So, which gives that is Vc sin omega ct plus Vm Vc by 2 cos omega c minus cos m of t minus m Vc by 2 cos omega c plus omega m of t. Okay. So, this is the final equation for an amplitude of an modulation. So, now from this what we can analyze, that this is the same equation which is there for carrier signal. Okay. So, this is LSB, that is lower sideband, and this is USB, which is called as an upper sideband here. Okay. And the amplitude of an LSB and USB are MVC by 2, and here MVC by 2 here. And the information contained in the amplitude modulation, these sidebands will be the same here with carrier signal here. Okay. So, which gives three components in amplitude modulated equation, that is carrier signal, LSB and USB here. Okay. So, now we will see how to plot and amplitude modulation signal in frequency domain. So, for frequency domain, if you have to analyze this signal, we have to make use of an spectrum analyzer here. So, in that we are going to see with respect to frequency. Okay. So, there you will look like the signal in this manner here. So, this will be F USB, this will be F LSB, this will be an FC here. Okay. And this will be amplitude of an the sidebands MVC by 2. Okay. So, if you calculate the bandwidth, so which is F2 minus F1, that is upper cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency. Upper cutoff frequency means USB, that is upper sideband, that is omega C plus omega M. So, which we can write FC plus FM minus, you can write FC minus FM here. Okay. So, from this FC plus FM minus FC plus FM, so which get cancelled, you require, you get an bandwidth is equals to 2 FM. So, this is the equation number 5. So, remember how much bandwidth will be required to transmit an AM signal, you require 2 FM here. Okay. And if you want to observe the AM signal in frequency domain using a spectrum analyzer, so you will look like the signal will be in this manner here. Okay. And in time domain, your signal will be in this form here. Okay. So, this is the total AM modulated signal here. Okay. Thank you.